Thanks. You piece of shit, you dog piece of fucking crap. And a 1, 2, and a 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. I knew this was gonna be a fucking piece of shit of a fucking problem. I bought a piece of fucking crap. And 1, 2, 3, 4. How many fucking times we gotta do this before we get it right? Okay. Okay, how about, let me touch, I've got 18 foot of cable. How about I take it and I fucking wind it around here where I won't step on the fucking thing, huh? And use my fucking head God gave me? That's asking a fucking lot. One, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3.
So here we are with the Bias Amp 2. We're going to go over how I got the effects open invitation. Maybe they should have named this something other than Bias Amp and Bias FX Effects. Bias sometimes is a little bit intimidating. It was to me when I first heard it. I just had the Spark 40 and using that, and one of my followers suggested why I'm not using the Bias FX 2 professional grade. And I said I was a little bit intimidated, didn't know what it was. And when I delved into it, it's not that difficult. It wasn't intimidating after I used it. Now that I've used it, I think that everybody's using it, and that's not the case. So I'd like to share with everybody the Bias Amps and the Bias FX 2 software from Positive Grid. And basically the Bias Amp you would use before the Bias FX. This allows you to create your own custom complete amplifier, including changing your tubes, changing your transformers, tapping out, changing your tubes, using a preamp. You can change the tubes and sound there. You change your speaker cabinets. You get a selection of Celestion. They're in partnership with them. So this does so much. And then you can go into the Bias FX and change your cabinets all over again, which would be ridiculous, but it gives you the option. The options are there to do what you want. On this particular program, I like this. Not better than FX, but in conjunction with, because it allows you to actually use name brand equipment. Like everybody's familiar, you go into, I shouldn't say everybody's familiar with, well, you know. So everybody's been using the Spark, or if you haven't, the Spark, if you want to use the Fender Reverb or the Twin Reverb, they actually call it the Luxverb, since they're not paying royalties, I believe, on it. So they changed the name. Same with their effects pedals. They have the Tube Screamer, like Ibanez. It's green. It matches in the color. It matches in the knobs, but they changed the name. But here, they don't. They've actually got Hi-Watt Marshall, the Dr. Z amps. They have the Orange amps, the Marshall, the Vox. There's no changing the names to try to, you know, get away from copyright, paying royalties or whatever. So it's much easier to actually find the Fender Vival. Remember, what I was actually looking for is, I know Carlos Santana uses a Mesa Boogie. There it is, the Mesa Boogie. So it's pretty simple to get the Mesa Boogie. I didn't have to think about, with the Spark, are they calling it the Seiji or the Mabu or the Megi? I mean, they take the names. I don't know how they figure these names, but they're not the same. So here it is. It's very easy for me. They have, this is in the blues category. The Mesa Boogie is also in other categories, but we don't need to go over that now. So basically what you do is, I tap on it. It says download it. I downloaded it. And then I brought it back into the amp, and there it is. So the Lone Star Open Invitation amp. There's the Lone Star by itself. And I modified it a little bit. Why not? That's what this program is all about. I went into the power amp, I changed a couple tubes, I went into the transformer, I changed a couple transformers, a tube, I actually used the tone stack this time and added the preamp. I didn't really mess with any knobs too much. It's overwhelming. I could sit here for days and weeks on end, tailoring just this one amp. So I got the sound I liked, and then you have to save it. I saved it. I shared it to the Tone Cloud. For some reason, it's under my name, Charles Ross, instead of Ross Recording Studio, but that's okay. There it is, in the tone cloud. So since I'm using studio recording and not live recording, I'm not playing out of a live speaker. Everything is into the computer. So what I do is open up Positive Grid from the plugins, Bias FX, and it appears here. And how I got Open Invitation Sound to the Bias FX 2. Now this is a different computer. This is not a touchscreen. I bought the touchscreen just for Bias Amp 2. So I wouldn't have to be sitting there trying to use a mouse changing tube. So then I went to the Tone Cloud. Went to my name, Charles Ross, and voila, there was my Open Invitation amp that I created from Bias Amp. Downloaded it, and it seamlessly came right here. Then I added the Celestion T75's, the Reverb 1, .1. It's the lowest setting I could possibly get on Reverb. The distortion was enough. I tried a bunch of distortion pedals. As you can see, I could add on drives, distortion. It really killed the sound, so I didn't add any extra distortion pedals or anything. The compressor was added in. What I did add in extra would be a little bit of chorus. And this one I added on compressor. I'm gonna keep which type of compressor. Classified information, I'm not gonna tell you it was the brick wall. I'm not gonna discuss the settings if it's full, wet, or dry. But yeah, there it is. And then the other thing where I started was one channel. And after I got the recording done, I duplicated that channel. Threw this one to about 8 o'clock, this one to about 4 o'clock to get a stereo separation. Added chorus only on the left channel and added compressor only on the right. Give it a little bit of different tones between two. And as you see, we changed it to the session view. Here it is. There's the meters. And it sounds great, doesn't it? So that's how I get it into the Ableton. I don't use the Bias FX by itself if I'm recording. There's no need to open it up by itself. It's using approximately 25-30% computer power. Running here. And about 25%. So then we would save it, export the file. It exports it in a wave format. Done. Then, since I'm playing Open Invitation, I am playing to the music, we have to get the music into Premiere. I'm using Adobe Premiere editing software. So I go to YouTube. Open Invitation. Find what version I want. I copy it. I paste that software into iTunes Studio. If I'm using just music alone, I leave it in the MP4 format, then I can just drop it right into my video and leave it there. Or I can convert it into a WAV file. So this file in the green is the soundtrack from Carlos. His video is also in the picture right here. And then I add my file that I created from Novation, the Ableton software. I drop that in. And I also use that's interesting. Focusrite Scarlett 2i2 is where the guitar is plugged into. That goes into the Ableton Live. I'm using 10 on one computer. I'm using 11 on another computer. Focusrite into the Novation Ableton software. Then that is recorded into this green track here, dropped into Adobe Premiere. And from the Adobe Premiere, I add my video footage that I have recorded. And that's about it. After it's edited together, change the colors, get the color right, effects, audio, captions, here's all the channels muted, except for my guitar. Take my guitar out. That would be right off the phones. I cut those soundtracks out. Just use them to guide it to the... Use it to guide the reference of mine. That's about it. Peace out. Thanks for watching.